Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. In today's video I'm going to be giving you an update on the BMW 535D E61 that I bought a few episodes ago. If you're interested in watching the video where we went and collected it and I gave you a brief walk through it, click up here and you can go and watch that. But in this video I'm going to be going through how I feel about the car 2 months later, how it's been, have I had any issues, is there anything I want to do to it, blah 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 blah. So if you're new around here, make sure you hit subscribe to stay up to date with every video I post on the channel. I know recently there's been a lot of mini content, that's why I'm switching it up a little bit and bringing you some Beamer content. Obviously that car came and there's been no videos about it since, which is a good thing because, you know, we make videos when we repair cars, so you know, it has been pretty good and we're going to go through all of that today. So a quick recap, I bought the car for £1,550 from a dealership in Bedford. Definitely don't recommend them, the service was all a bit shady, the whole car is a little bit not as advertised, but there we go. So basically went down to Bedford, Owen gave me a lift, went down with Tyler, picked the car up. I'd already put a deposit of £250 down, which they were quite insistent on, a £250 non-refundable deposit. That probably should have been the first red flag, but there we go. So we got there, the condition of the car was a lot worse than we'd expected, but I kind of needed the car for motorway miles for work. I was doing more and more miles for work, which meant that having a Subaru that ran on petrol and had a boxer engine, which are notoriously bad for fuel, was not really viable anymore. I was spending a lot of time on the motorway and a lot of time driving around cities and towns, so the manual gearbox was getting a little bit tedious. Obviously I do like driving manuals and I've still got the Mini which is a manual, but I wanted to shift over to auto just for the whole laziness really. There's no benefit to an automatic gearbox really for me, and yeah, I thought this was the right car. So in short, the car has been absolutely great. We had a few issues which, as I said, we'll go through. So the condition of the car was not as we expected, but for 1500 quid we can't really complain. So there we go. So obviously I sold my Subaru Legacy to purchase this car. As I said before, it's a really great car and it still is to this day a great car. I would have it back in a heartbeat, but as I mentioned, unfortunately it wasn't just not very good on fuel, but other than that, a really, really solid car. So the day I purchased the car, it drove home pretty faultless, no issues. It came up saying that there was a flat tire on the way home, but after we just sort of reset the tire pressure on it, in the iDrive system, it was fine and I've not had an issue since. I did notice, with a very limited amount of paperwork that came with the car, there was a little key tag type thing that said rear puncture. So I'm assuming the wheel was repaired, and they just not reset the tire pressure in the iDrive system. Then once we got home, me and a few mates decided just to have a few quiet drinks and get something to eat. So we took it for a trip over to Tesco, which for me is the other side of town. It's where we do a lot of the car meets and stuff. So then literally as we just left the Tesco car park after we'd been shopping, we were driving and it come up saying transmission fault, engine fault, ABS fault, everything, do not pass go, do not collect £200, that sort of thing. So I pulled in, stopped the car, turned it off, and then it wouldn't start again. Now this was the start of a long run of electrical issues, which I'm glad to say I got to the bottom of literally 2 or 3 days ago. So that happened, I got a jump start, drove home faultless, all the faults cleared, everything went, I was happy. So got it home, then basically bought a battery, because I tested the voltage on the battery and it had dropped down to like 6 volts. So assuming the battery was dead, tested the voltage while the car was running and I was getting 13.9 volts or something like that, which was right for the car to be running. So I knew the alternator wasn't dodgy, so I changed the battery out. Anyway, changed the battery out, everything was fine. About a week ago I was getting ready to go to work, and the car just didn't start. Checked the battery voltage and it was sitting at 8 volts, which is obviously not enough to start the car. So I managed to jumpstart the car using the Lexus, got that up and running, and away we go. Went to work, was at work for a day, came home, no problem. Next day I had to go back to work again. I usually work at home every day, So I had to go back into work again, come out the next morning, battery was dead, car wouldn't start, jumped it, perfect, no problem, to work and back, no problem. So I knew there was a battery drain issue. The issue was, I just didn't know where it was. So to try and find out where the issue was, I went into the fuse box and started pulling fuses in some sort of order for systems that I had a feeling were staying online, or you could almost understand that were staying active when the car was off. So for example, the CD changer, the parking sensors, and the airbag system, not airbag as in suspension airbag system. I'm not disabling the airbags. So that led to the battery voltage staying at about 12.5 to 12.3 volts consistently every time I get in the car now. So I'm pretty happy that the battery drain issue is resolved now, and that was my big gripe with the car. So that's a big thumbs up from me, because the car is now reliable. So some of the other issues it's had since day one, there's a airbag warning light on the car that needs to just be looked into. I need to read the code on it and have a look. I'm sure it's probably not much. The suspension bag system on the car sometimes pops up saying suspension level control fault or something like that. I've got a feeling it's just a sensor or a blocked up filter. Need to have a look into it, but again, just haven't had the time or the money really. So that hasn't been done. It does need a full service. That definitely needs to be done, because I've got no service history with it. So I need to do that just to look out for myself really. There is also still a very harsh judder when you brake. So if you're at high speed, like 60, 70, and you put your foot on the brake, the steering wheel will literally judder sort of like that. So that needs to be looked into. I'm pretty sure it's either warp discs or potentially tie rods. I know the brakes do need doing all round, so I'm gonna do that and then also get the tie rods out of the way too. But yeah, they're all the issues. Onto the good stuff. So it has been the most comfortable drive of my entire life. The seats are just so comfortable. I've done quite a few miles in it now, like a couple of thousand miles in it now. I've sat in traffic for a few hours. I've just driven it around town. It's been to car meets, and it really has been the most comfortable car. It's spacious enough that I can get friends in the back. I can get the dog in the boot. We've took it on multiple tip runs. We literally fit in half of an MX-5 into the car. We had the front bumper, the two wings, a door, a boot lid for the Mini. We had absolutely loads in there. It was stacked high and it was fine. It's an absolute machine. It's everything I wanted the car to be. It's now reliable, it's practical, it's fun, it's really comfortable, it's great on fuel, and it's not too bad to run. A full tank cost me about £83, but I can get roughly 550 miles out of that, which is not bad at all, in my opinion. On the motorway, it averages somewhere between 45 and 50 mpg, and around town, it's about 35 to 30 mpg. So it's pretty good. So of course, it's me. I'm never gonna ever leave a car standard, because I just don't think I'm capable of it, to be honest. I don't think I'm capable of leaving a car standard. So what I'd like to do, nice and simple, wind deflectors, black wheels, some sort of black wheels. I want to get rid of these, I don't like the look of them, so I get some new wheels that are black. Then I'd also like to get a map, a tune, that sort of thing, just to get a little bit more performance out of it. I don't know whether you can get a lot out of it. I need to have a look into it, but it's something I like to do just to get a little bit more out of it. And then obviously I want to do your normal stuff, your servicing and your brakes and stuff like that. So yeah, there's a few little bits that I want to do to it, but I'm not going to be putting coilovers on it, I'm not going to be putting an exhaust on it. So if you're here for that, you ain't going to get it really. I think car updates wise, that's probably it for the channel. I am working on a few things in the background, trying to get a new sort of variety of stickers out, a few new colours, maybe switch up the designs a little bit, just have a few new things on the go. I'm looking to basically purchase a vinyl printer soon, or a plotter. So yeah, I'm going to have the ability to change up the designs a little bit, which will be interesting. We're also looking at doing some t-shirts and some hoodies and stuff like that. And as I've, you know, mentioned before, not your just bog standard stick a logo on a t-shirt and then forget about it. it'd be more, you know, an actual design and something interesting. So yeah, that'll be coming hopefully soon. It just depends whether I get the time for it and I can find the right products with the right price range, that sort of thing. Also, while we're on the topic of the channel, we have nearly reached 400 subscribers, which to me is a really big milestone. So thank you to everyone that has subscribed. If you haven't already, make sure you go and click the subscribe button. It really does help out and makes me want to continue making more videos. But aside from that, I think that's it. So if you have enjoyed this BMW update video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and make sure you share it with your friends. Go and follow me on Instagram at GrindingGearsOfficial. I'll put it on the screen now. And also make sure you head over to my website, www.grindinggears.uk. Grab yourself one of the stickers I mentioned, and also you can grab yourself a mug. So thank you for watching this update video. Make sure you hit the like button and the subscribe button to stay up to date with the videos that I upload. I really do hope you enjoyed this video. But for now, I'll see you in the next one.